Hey, what's up, VC? It's Steve again, Harmless Rebel, and I'm going to do a quick review of the new Megadeth picture discs that came out yesterday. As soon as I saw that they were releasing these, I ordered two of them, and that's simply because these two particular records are near impossible to get on vinyl, and even when you do run across them on vinyl in good condition, they're well over $100. I've never actually seen either album in the wild. If I saw them in the wild, I would probably pay for them just because I am such a big fan of Megadeth. There's only a couple bands that if I run across one of their albums in the wild, I buy it regardless, and Megadeth is one of them. There's even a couple that weren't in the best condition that I bought because I knew friends were looking for them, so I would buy them and pass them on. So I'm not a big fan of picture discs, but like I said, it's Megadeth, and I've wanted these two albums on vinyl for quite a long time. So let's just kind of jump into it. The first one, being 1992's Countdown to Extinction. And there's the front, and there's the back cover, and then 1994's Euthanasia. This is one I kicked myself about. I actually had Euthanasia on vinyl back when it came out. I went to the CD release at Zia in Phoenix on Thunderbird, and they had copies of it on vinyl, and they had a deal. I don't remember what the deal was, but it was like the CD, the album, and the t-shirt. So I bought that, and it wasn't much. I didn't make a lot of money back then, so it can't have been more than you know, 25, 30 bucks for the set. And I would venture to say it was probably about 25 bucks. But again, I'm a Megadeth fan and I bought it. I don't think I ever even opened the album. I think I ended up giving it to a friend of mine, you know, and originals of that. Like I said, they go for well over 100 bucks at this point. But you know, again, the artwork is really good. This was actually the shirt that I had. And let's see. Once again, here is Countdown to Extinction. First and foremost, let's start with the bad. The bad is it's in these ridiculous plastic sleeves. These things drive me nuts. If you look, they're already busted on the ends, which drives me crazy. I hate these plastic sleeves. So, I mean, I'll get some nice sleeves and put them into those in a few minutes here once I'm done with the video. I was really, when I first heard that they were releasing them on picture disc, you know, I wasn't real excited about it. Like I said, I'm not a fan of picture discs. I wish they would have released them on vinyl. But I was hoping that they would at least do like Iron Maiden did. That's the one thing that Iron Maiden did right with their picture discs, is they put them in normal sleeves, you know, so you didn't have to worry about these pieces of, you know, these garbage plastic sleeves. That being said, that's about the end of the bad that I can say about these things. First and foremost, they sound amazing. You hear some real slight, real low noise between tracks and the quiet spots. A lot of the new records that are being pressed these days are like that. To me, that's just a pressing issue with pressing these days. You know, a lot of the vinyl that I get, brand new, sounds that way. So I'm not going to really fault them for that. They were remastered, from what I understand, by Dave Mustaine, if I read it correctly, or if I read it correctly. Like I said, they sound amazing. It's a really high quality pressings. It sounds amazing. I was really blown away by how good these do sound on picture discs, or on picture disc. I do think they sound better than Iron Maiden did on picture disc, without doubt. They didn't, at least, I haven't listened to all of Countdown yet. I'm sorry, I haven't listened to all of Euthanasia yet. I've only listened to the first couple songs, but I listened to all of Countdown, and I don't notice any major changes to any of the songs. You know, sometimes when they remaster, they screw up some of the songs. The songs all sound the way I remember them sounding, you know, and these are songs that I know every, I mean, I know how to play every one of these on drums. I know how to play every one of these songs on bass. I know a couple of the songs on guitar. My guitar was never fast enough to play. I've never been able to play as fast as Dave Mustaine, but I know all the drum tracks. I know these songs. These are all also two of the most, probably the most played albums of high school for me. You know, the first one came out my sophomore year. The second one came out my senior year. And I played these nonstop in my car at the house. When my band was practicing, we would always... there were a couple songs that we would play. We would play Sweating Bullets. I think Train of Consequence was the other one that we would play on a regular basis. It's just kind of just to have fun, you know. But they sound really good. It's not just, they didn't just raise the volume levels. They actually cleaned them up. The quality, like I said, it's really amazing. I've never heard the original pressing, so I can't give you a good comparison between the original pressings or even the MoFi. I think there was a MoFi of, I think it was Euthanasia. Don't quote me on that. They did a MoFi of one of them, though, which, again, well over $100 in good condition. You know, I do recommend you guys go out. If you don't have these two albums, go out and buy them. Like I said, I'm not going to seek out the first few albums. I have all of those on vinyl. Actually, I'm missing one, and it's on its way now. I did a deal, a trade with a member of the VC. I am hopeful that they release the next couple albums after this. Cryptic Writings, a lot of people don't like that album. I do. I thought it was a good album. It's not as good as these, but it was still a great album in my opinion. There's a lot of songs on there. I'd also like to see Risk get released on picture disc, just because I've only ever seen one copy of Risk, and I think they wanted like $400 for it. Risk had two songs on it that I really liked, but I thought the whole album was okay. It's not the Dave Mustaine that I like. However, it's still I love Megadeth. And I would also like to see The World Needs a Hero. Like I said, those are the three hardest to find. And when you do find them, they're in the multi-hundreds of dollar range. So, like I said, I would like to see those. I would actually like to see, actually, it's funny that I have this sitting here. I'd like to see this one on vinyl, too. This is That One Night. It's a double disc from Argentina. That's pretty much it, guys. Like I said, if you don't have these, I do recommend picking them up. The others you can get on black vinyl. I would recommend you getting them on black vinyl. I'm not sure about the first couple albums. I've never been a fan of the mastering of the first two albums, so they may be worth checking out just because, like I said, they were remastered. A really good job was done. Very high quality. So... excuse me. That's pretty much it, VC. Tell me what you think. Those of you who also pre-ordered these, if you didn't get them yet, they, like I said, they were guaranteed by yesterday. For some reason, mine showed up today. I'm not disappointed by that. Again, check them out. Love you, VC. Take care.